सर्व मंगल मांगल्य शिवे सर्वार्थ साधिके शरण्य त्र्यंबिके गौरी नारायणी नमास्ते।
Doctor, my mother is unwell, doctor.
You bring her here, I'll check her up.
No, doctor, she can't come here. She is unconscious. She doesn't say anything. Come with me, doctor, please.
Okay, son, I'll come right away.
Doctor, what's happened to my mother?
Nothing, my dear. There is no need to worry. Come to the clinic in the morning and take medicines from me, okay?
Okay.
Doctor, will she become all right?
I can't say anything. She doesn't have any kind of illness. She's under sort of trauma.
Yes, doctor. I hope God doesn't let anyone go through this trauma.
And yes, please remember one more thing. It's very important to make sure she eats the right food. If she doesn't eat well, the medicines won't help her.
Mom, come on, Mom, take your medicine. Eat, Mom.
I know, Mom. You would always feed me first and then eat. But I've already eaten. Honestly, Mom, I've had my food. Please eat. Mom, don't cry. Why are you crying? That person will cry who has made us cry.
Thank you.
अजय हे यू आर नॉट रेडी एज येट गेट रेडी क्विकली आई मेक द ब्रेकफास्ट फॉर यू लुक टिल यू डोंट ईट योर मदर विल ऑल्सो नॉट ईट
आई बी राइट देयर आंट
Where is Ajay?
Good morning, Mom. Wow, great. Today my mom's looking very beautiful. Let me see. Come on, Mom. Let's have breakfast. Let's see what my aunt has made. Oh, pudding. Look, Mom. Come on. Open your mouth. Open. Now, Mom, you feed me with your hands.
Has Munni had her milk?
Yes, Mom. Munni has had her milk, and Father's even gone out to get the medicines. And as soon as he comes back, we'll give her the medicines. You know, Mom, Munni has become very naughty now. She doesn't listen to anyone.
Come on, son.
Okay, Mom. Shall I leave now? Bye, Mom.
No, Ajay. You are that son which every mother will be proud of. You have done everything for your mother. You should be very happy. Your mother has started talking. You have taken such good care of her.
You also take such good care of my mother. Being a neighbor, you have done so much for us that even a relative wouldn't do.
Okay, enough. You talk too much now.
Okay, aunt. I'm leaving.
Hey Ajay,
huh? Hey you.
Yes. Where are you going?
I'm going to Mumbai. Miss the bus.
Really? I'm also going there. Come, sit.
Thank you. I've met you after so many years. How are you?
I'm fine, yaar. How's your mom?
Mom's absolutely fine. You tell me, how are you doing? I went to Pune a couple of times but couldn't meet up with you.
I'm living in Mumbai now. You could say I'm leading my life traveling between Mumbai and Pune. From the time my parents passed away, I had to take the entire responsibility of the business here.
Your parents passed away?
2 years ago, the airline's mishap which happened at the Bangalore airport, in which everyone died, my parents were also amongst them.
I'm sorry, bro.
Why are you going to Mumbai?
I'm looking for someone.
Who?
Success.
La 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 la.
Hey, wait up, Fatty.
Huh?
I will answer the phone. I am the head servant of this house. Understand?
Babulal, why do you answer the phone? You don't remember anything. You just answer whatever you feel like saying. And Mr. Chopra shouts on us because of you.
Shut up! Get out of here! Go and wash vessels in the kitchen. Take this. Don't remember. And me?
This is Mr. Bajoria calling from Ahmedabad. I have canned bottles and tumblers. May I know who is this?
I am the head servant of this house, Babulal.
Head also and servant as well. Look, Babulal, I want to come to Mumbai to talk about my son's marriage proposal. Could you put Mr. Chopra on the line?
Just a minute. Fatty?
What?
Who's Mr. Chopra over here?
Babulal, Mr. Chopra is our boss.
Hello, Mr. Chopra. Wait just a moment, I'll find him for you.
Babulal.
Huh?
If Dad calls, please tell him that from college I'll be going straight to the health club, okay?
Yes, madam.
Good morning.
Good morning, Marco.
Look, now there's no one here and the phone is kept like this. If I'm not here for a single day, I wonder what'll happen to Chopra Palace. Hello?
Sir, how are you?
I'm fine.
I have called you to find out when it's possible to come and see the girl.
You can come whenever you like. It is your own house.
Okay, okay. And sir, tell me, how is everything else?
Well, what should I say now? Potatoes and onions have become so expensive,
it's completely unbelievable.
Just look at tomatoes. Chilies, ginger.
Hey, who is this speaking?
Me, I'm the head servant of this house, Babulal speaking. Ramchandra, what's wrong with you?
You should have told me first. I've been laughing for so long. I want to talk to Mr. Chopra. Give him the phone.
Hello? Mr. Chopra has gone to the college.
Mr. Chopra? Is still studying in college?
Ooh, she's come. She's come, my love. She's come. I'm going.
Oh, Lord. Today, if she looks at me, then I will definitely offer half a coconut at your temple.
Move out.
Welcome. Good morning.
Good morning.
Wah.
Hi, Anjali.
Huh? Hi, Seema.
Did you get my history notes?
Yes, I did. And the love story too, which was kept inside it.
Love story?
Come here.
Oh.
So, what's going on?
What do you mean?
I'll tell you. Look at this. Seema, I do understand that in this love story, the heart belongs to you. But who does the arrow belong to which has pierced your heart?
Anjali, not now. When the time comes, I'll tell you everything.
All right.
Now let's go to the canteen.
Hey, you want to miss the lecture on psychology?
Today, I'm not going to attend any class. When Ravi comes, I'll tell him. He will give me the notes.
Hi, Seema.
Huh?
Hi.
He's here. You just thought of him and he's already here.
That's all. Such a small issue. I will copy all the psycho notes and give them to you. You do not need to attend the lecture.
I knew it. You're the only one in the entire college that I can trust completely.
Thank you.
Okay, so then I'll leave.
Okay.
Bye.
Three blind. Where did it go? Hey, what are you doing?
What kind of a lover are you? You've come after so many days. You should have been waiting eagerly for your girlfriend to come here. But you?
Yeah.
You're sitting here with your eyes glued to the book.
Because books are better than a girlfriend. Give it to me. At least books don't make you wait.
You're angry.
I am very angry.
Ouch!
Do you know, you are exactly 6 1/4 minutes late.
I'm sorry. Forgive me.
No. I will never forgive you. No.
Okay. So then punish me.
Shut up. Your punishment is that until I'm reading my book, you'll keep on kissing me. You keep quiet.
Oh, God.
ting 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 ting.
Ajay, I don't like meeting quietly in this manner.
Hey, I don't like it either, Seema. But what to do? We just can't help it. Look, right now nobody should get to know what's going on between two of us. Because if your dad gets the slightest hint that you are in love with an ordinary unemployed boy like me, he will never forgive you. And he will never accept me. Hey, Seema, don't be sad. Have faith in me. The day is not far when you will become mine forever and ever. And after that, ting, 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 ting. But there's one thing. I don't like this habit of you coming late every day. Show me your watch. Now, the time on this watch, I will set it according to the time.
Today, my sister Priya was supposed to come from Shimla.
Really?
I had to go to the airport also. Mm-hmm. It's become so late. She must have reached home by now. How many people are you, Babulal?
I am just one person, Gabbar ma'am.
I mean, how many servants are there in this house?
I'll tell you right now, madam. Three.
And you?
I am a person, madam.
So are you not a servant?
Actually, sir takes such good care of me that I have forgotten that I am a servant.
You also forgot to send the car to the airport.
What was the need to send the car to the airport? There are aircrafts there, right?
Shut up!
Heard that?
Where is Daddy?
He is no more, madam.
What?
He was in the helicopter. And he was feeling very cold. He switched off the fan of the helicopter, so he had to leave this world.
Whom are you talking about?
About my father.
Oh, no! Get out! Out!
Priya!
Hi, Seema!
How are you?
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Fine, but I'm very angry with you. Why didn't you come to the airport to pick
me
up?
Sorry, Priya. I had an extra class today.
Okay, you couldn't come, but Daddy could have come at least.
You know how Dad is. He enjoys only two things. One is to increase his business and the other is to race cars. He must be occupied with one of these two things.
Look, I don't want to hear anything. Our company's production must go up at any cost.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, Mr. Mehta.
The workers have appealed to the management that they should be given houses to stay.
The company is giving them a job for which they are getting a salary. Apart from this, they are not going to get anything else. You can go now.
Right, sir.
Desai.
Yes, sir.
As you know, we have taken over Girdhari Lal's factory. Go and take charge of it.
Yes.
And yes, from today, this factory will be called Seema Garments.
Sir, that reminds me that there have been a number of calls from the house. Priya madam has arrived from Shimla.
Huh?
Daddy!
How is my daughter?
Daddy!
How are you?
She's fine, but her mood is very bad.
And why is my daughter in a bad
mood? Why are you so late?
I had some important work in the office. I have bought a new garment factory for Seema.
Wow!
Now, Seema garments will be famous all over Europe.
Mm. Wow! And what about me?
You? What do you want?
Sports car.
That's all. A sports car. You will get it. Thank you, Babulal. Babulal.
Yes, sir.
What is this?
Soup, sir.
Soup, sir?
Yes.
This is a finger bowl. You wash your hands in this after eating.
Talia, what is this you have done? Something which is used after eating, you have kept it before eating? What if sir had squeezed the lime and then drunk it thinking it's a soup?
Shut up. Go and get the soup.
Yes.
And you go as well.
Come on. Daddy Baldy, I'm going to get you for
this. Hello, baby.
Hi.
Hello.
Daddy, tomorrow you won't go anywhere. You will stay only with us.
In fact, no. Because tomorrow both of you will come to Chennai with me. I'm going to take part for the last time in the car race.
Wow, car race!
But how can I come?
Why?
Tomorrow are my practical exams.
Oh, yes. Your studies are important, but if you...
Oh, come on, Seema. If you come, it will be great fun.
Why are you thinking like that? Just think that wherever you are, your sister is there too. And just watch, Daddy. Like every time, you will win this race as well.
Yes, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, Mr. Chopra.
Hello, Kulkarni. Hello, how are you?
Is it true that you're participating in this race for the last time?
Yes, Kulkarni. Till the time I'm participating, nobody else will be able to win. Until number one doesn't leave, how will number two ever get a chance to win?
That is fine, but see to it that number two doesn't get that chance in this race itself. There is a new boy, Vicky Malhotra. I have seen him practicing. His timing is amazing. He is the only one who can give you stiff competition.
Where is he?
There he is, standing near car number 32.
Whether it's a race of life or of cars, I have never learned to lose.
Yes! Whoever this Vicky, Bicky, Mickey, Sicky is, they are of no comparison to my dad. Am I right, Dad?
You're right, darling.
Okay, Mr. Chopra. All the best.
Thank you, Kulkarni.
Mr. Madan Chopra is participating in this race for the last time, and Mr. Madan Chopra is confident that this time also he'll be the winner.
Best of luck!
Now what we need to watch out for is that who will be the competition for Mr. Madan Chopra? At one hand, we have Mr. Madan Chopra's tremendous experience, and on the other hand, we have Vicky Malhotra, the new and dynamic driver. Vicky Malhotra is now reaching, but Madan Chopra is trying to catch up and overtake Vicky Malhotra. And Vicky continues with full confidence. But what do we see now? Madan Chopra moving ahead. What remains to be seen is who will stay ahead. And suddenly, Vicky has increased the speed and is now leading, leaving Madan Chopra behind. Seems like Vicky will create a new history of sports, and Madan Chopra will have to accept the defeat.
Yes, Dad!
Will it be Vicky Malhotra or Madan Chopra? We have Madan Chopra's experience on the other hand, and Vicky Malhotra's passion. Madan Chopra has left Vicky Malhotra behind. As the race starts, it's first lap, but Vicky is quite close. Some other cars also leading, and there has been a mishap. But luckily, the driver is not hurt much. What's waiting to be seen and which car will stay behind in the race? And Vicky Malhotra is now leading in his car number 32. Madan Chopra, with all his experience, comes closer to him. Car number 11 is also quite close. Vicky Malhotra is looking very confident, but Madan Chopra overtakes him.
Yes!
He's leading in the race. And he's leading in the race. Vicky Malhotra is now tailing him. The race might come to a pulsating end, but let's see who wins the race. And now Vicky Malhotra has accelerated and he's leading the pack. He has overtaken Madan Chopra. Let's see who's going to win this race. Now you can see sometimes Vicky and sometimes Madan Chopra leads the race. Now let's see who's going to win this race. Madan Chopra is tailing him right now. He's trying to overtake him. I guess he will.
Faster, Daddy!
I guess Madan Chopra will overtake him. He's on his tail right now. I guess Madan Chopra is going to win this race. He's trying to overtake Vicky Malhotra. Let's see what's the result of this race. The race is coming to an end. This is the last lap. Madan Chopra is leading the race. And Vicky Malhotra has decreased his speed suddenly. Madan Chopra wins this race!
Yay! Yes! Daddy! Great, Daddy, I love you!
Thank you, darling. Thank you.
I was so scared that you might lose, but at the last minute you accelerated and left that number 32 behind and wondering who he's up against.
Thank you, sweetie. Thank you. Kulkarni.
Yes, tell me.
I want to meet the driver of car number 32. Okay?
Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Congratulations, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Were you having some kind of a problem with your car?
No, sir.
You were winning. How did you lose?
I've been a fan of yours since years. You've been like a teacher to me. And I didn't want you to lose your last race.
Which means that you lost the race deliberately?
Sometimes to win something, you need to lose something.
What is it that you want to win?
Your blessings.
I like the style of yours, young man. By the way, where are you from?
From Mumbai, sir. Car racing is my hobby. And dealing in sports cars is my business.
Oh. I'm looking for a sports car for my daughter. If you know of any good car, then let me know.
I'm reaching Mumbai day after. I'll definitely show her some cars.
Sir, we want a picture of yours along with the car.
1 minute, I'll be there. Okay, Vicky.
Bye-bye.
See you in Mumbai.
Have a good day, sir.
Priya, I'm in the clubhouse.
Okay, Dad. Excuse me. My name is...
Priya Chopra. And you want to know that why I lost the race? For you. You're the one who said that in comparison to your father, any Vicky, Mickey, Chicky, Licky doesn't stand a chance. And if this Hickey, Mickey, Licky, Chicky would have won the race, it would have broken your heart. And how can I break the heart of such a beautiful girl? That's why I said, sometimes in order to win something, you have to lose something. And the person who wins even after losing is called a gambler. What is he called?
Gambler.
Oh, no.
कर मैं बाजीगर, दिल वालों का मैं दिलबर,
बाजीगर ओ बाजीगर, तू है बड़ा जादूगर।
ओ दिल लेके दिल दिया है सौदा, प्यार का किया है दिल की बाजी, जीता दिल हार कर,
बाजीगर ओ बाजीगर,
बाजीगर मैं बाजीगर। धड़कता है ये दिल,
बोलो ना क्या कह रहा है,
पास आओ बता दूं,
ना बाबा डर लग रहा है,
मुझको गलत ना समझना, बाजीगर मैं बाजीगर,
बाजीगर ओ बाजीगर,
बाजीगर मैं बाजीगर।
In the race, Daddy participated. So then who did you lose to?
To the one who lost to Daddy.
Who lost to Daddy?
The person who won me over.
Who won you over?
That one who lost to Daddy in spite of almost winning.
Oh no, did Daddy win the race or lose?
Dad won the race after almost losing. But I lost.
What are all these things you're saying? You're saying something which I don't understand. Tell me exactly what happened.
It was an amazing race, Seema. Amazing race. At first sight, he made such a move that it captured my heart and I was love struck totally.
Who are you talking about? What's wrong with you?
I am in love, Seema. Love, romance, passion, love.
Oh my God, you're in love.
Yes, and if you see him, you will throw yourself out of the 20th floor.
I'm willing to jump out. But at least let me see him once.
Not just a glimpse, I will make you meet him. Tomorrow he's gonna come to show me a sports car. I'll bring him to your college.
Okay, but bring him early, okay? I have to go for a friend's birthday party as well.
Okay. Beautiful. Dad's gonna go crazy when he sees the car.
I'm also crazy.
If you like this car so much, then why are you giving it to Dad?
Hey, which idiot is talking about the car? Is this any age to be in love with cars? This is the time to be in love with beautiful girls.
Today, Seema will be very happy to meet you. I have to meet her in college at 1. I've praised you so much that she's gone completely crazy. I've told her that you're so handsome and so romantic and you're so passionate. How many cylinders does this car have?
8.
It must be fun driving it, right?
Yes, it is.
Shall I drive?
No, you won't drive it at all.
Just stop the car! Stop the car!
Okay. Hey, what happened, Priya?
Ice cream!
Ice cream? Such madness for an ice cream.
Get me one, please.
Hey, you don't get any ice cream in all here.
Okay then. Coconut water, please.
Coconut water. Okay, I'll get it right away. Idiot. Hey, give me an ice cream. I mean some coconut water.
I'm going on a long drive!
Yes, coming. Long drive?
Bye.
Hey, Priya, wait!
Wow, what a beauty! Hey, there's a hot chick behind the car!
Look at her! Look. She wants to overtake! Hey. Don't let her go!
Don't let her go! Block her way! Don't let her overtake!
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey!
You were driving very fast, right?
Does this road belong to your father?
Wow, you're saying very spicy things. Now let's see how spicy you taste.
You!
The bitch!
Hold up! Hey! Come on, let's go after her. Come on! Where is she?
There she is!
Come on!
She's running over there! Follow her! Wait! Hey, how did you fall?
Hey, what happened? Did the girl hit you?
Not the girl, the guy with the jacket!
Yeah. Hey, stop!
Hey, wait!
The water is over.
It's over? Now what do you want?
The Colonel.
Yeah.
Okay, coconut with the Colonel.
Colonel?
Colonel.
There he is!
Huh? Come on, let's go!
Hey, oh no. What have you guys done to yourselves? Why don't you guys be careful? Sometimes you're falling from this side, sometimes from that side, sometimes from above, sometimes... Seems like you're all out of the circus. Look, friends, this is a place for lovers.
You have come here for romance, and we are here for your procession.
Oh, so you guys are here for my procession?
Yes. No.
Why didn't you guys tell me before? Darling, These guys really enjoy music and dance. So you do one thing, sit down here for a while, and I will fix them and come.
What?
Yes, you just watch. Hey, where did you go? Come on, you also come. Here you go.
Oh!
Take this file and go to court.
Yes, sir.
May I call up Commissioner Uncle, please?
Are you the Commissioner's niece or what?
Let me call up first, then I'll tell you how I'm related to the Commissioner, okay?
Oh, so now you're trying to scare a constable by saying that you're related.
Priya?
Huh? Hey, Karan, you?
Hello, Priya.
What a surprise. You look really smart in the uniform.
Oh, really? Thanks.
Vicky, this is Karan. We studied together in Shimla. Karan, this is my friend Vicky.
Hi, Karan. Hi. How are you?
Karan? You know what? I was driving and these boys chased me and they...
I'm sure they must be troubling you. Don't worry. I'll take care of them. Why don't you come inside, please?
Some other time, Karan. As it is, this has taken a lot of time.
Okay.
And Priya, you better hurry up. Seema must be waiting for us in our college.
It's 3 o'clock. She was supposed to go for her friend's party. She must have already left by now.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Come on, open your mouth. Little more. Not so much, a bit more.
What's that crap? I know it all. I got my own life, you got your own life. Be your own life, I set me free. Mind your business, I live my business. You know everything, Papa, know it all. Very little knowledge is dangerous. Stop fighting me. Stop yelling me. It's my life.
Hi.
Hey, come on in. Come on. Dad! I can't come!
You can even learn from me. Little knowledge is dangerous. It's my life. It's my life.
I can't leave them and come out.
Wait, why aren't you calling him inside? Who should I call? The one you're waving at.
I was calling Charlie to dance.
Hey, she's calling me.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Enjoy yourself.
I'm coming.
May I dance with you? Okay, tell me something. Why didn't you come inside in the party today?
Seema, you know it, don't you? I get embarrassed with these fancy friends of yours. I don't really like it. And you know, I came till the door so that I could tell you that I'm going home for a few days.
What? What will I do for so many days?
Oh yes. I know. You can spend the time with your Charlie Chaplin. Hey, why are you getting angry? I was just joking. Come on, let's have some snacks. Come.
I am giving you a strict warning. The boy who is going to come and see Seema, madam, has already arrived. But you uneducated people don't come in front of him. Along with the Chopra household, my reputation will also be spoiled, understand? And today a special tea will be made. A special tea for a special occasion. After drinking which, the boy will immediately agree for the marriage. And this tea...
Oh.
Shh. I will make that tea.
Babulal, did your father even make
Don't
tea?
Don't talk about my father. He used to make coffee. Bring me a cab. Oh, today I will make tea with saffron.
That's not saffron, that's turmeric.
And you're in a big hurry, shut up, fatty.
Bloody hell.
This one.
Oh no, he's making nuisance of himself. And over there, guests are waiting for the tea.
Look, Mr. Madan, I have one and only one son. Whatever I have belongs to him, isn't it? You know, I have 3 factories. All are filled with plastic wares. Whenever you need boxes, bottles or tumblers for having a bath, just let me know. I'll take care of it.
Babulal, please wait.
Hey, shut up! And don't you dare come outside. Understood?
Thalia?
Yes?
He has taken boiled water. He hasn't put any tea leaves in it. Instead, he has put salt in it.
My only
Listen
son.
To
Sir, one and only.
There's a call from Mr. Singhania.
Excuse me, please have some tea. I will be right back.
Yes, please go. Work first. In case Mr. Singhania needs buckets and tumblers, then please suggest my name. Make some tea quickly. Everything is ours. My son has studied in America and come. If you have any doubts, you can talk to him in English and make sure about it. My son. My little pet. My little baby!
Daddy?
What is it?
There are no tea leaves in it.
Rich people drink tea in this way. Drink it up quickly.
Tea? Huh? Where is the tea? Huh? Where is the tea?
Thank you. Come, please sit.
Hey, did you people have some tea or not?
Mr. Chopra, the tea in your house is like nectar. Really, what do you say, son?
Seema is here.
Hi.
Come, I have a surprise for you.
What surprise?
Just come on.
Come, Seema dear.
Hello, Daddy.
This is my daughter, Seema. Seema, this is Mr. Bijoria. And this is her son, Kundan.
Hello.
Hello, hello. I have understood everything after seeing both of them. They are a perfect match for each other. Now you just quickly give us your consent for the wedding.
Fine. We will look for an auspicious day and finalize the engagement next week.
Seema, please try and understand my problem. You know it very well. I'm not successful. And I'm not in a position that I can come up to your father and talk to him.
I don't know anything. If you cannot come and talk to Daddy, then I will talk to him. I will tell him everything about you and make him accept you.
But Seema...
Ajay, we have only 1 week left with us.
Next week, Daddy has finalized my engagement.
All right, Seema. You meet me tomorrow. I'll think of something.
Okay.
Seema, please get married to the boy that your father wants you to.
What
What is this you're saying?
Yes. I've given it a lot of thought. We don't have any other way apart from this.
Ajay, I want to reach my destination. And my destination is you. I cannot live without you.
So then we have only one option left. The option that can unite us forever.
What?
Suicide.
Suicide?
Are you ready?
If the end of our love is death, then I'll be happy to die for you.
I, Ajay Sharma, being fully conscious and aware, I'm writing this.
I, Seema Chopra, being fully conscious and aware, I'm writing this.
That without any kind of pressure, but because I'm unhappy with my life.
That without any kind of pressure, but because I'm unhappy in life.
I'm committing suicide.
I'm committing suicide.
Nobody is blamed for this.
Nobody is to be blamed for this.
Here, sign it. Crazy girl.
What happened? Why are you laughing?
Because you've passed. You've got 100%
marks. 100%
marks? Yes. I was just testing you. Testing your love. Testing your faith, Seema.
But this suicide note?
Weak people try to end their lives. And Ajay is not weak. That he loses battle of life so easily. We'll go to the court tomorrow itself and get married. Exactly at 1 o'clock, reach the registrar's office. I'll be waiting there for you. Now are you happy?
Thank you.
Close between 1 and 2. So that, now you've come late and it's lunchtime here.
Hey, how would I know that in this office, everyone feels hungry between 1 and 2, huh? Ridiculous.
Now what will we do for half an hour? If someone sees us over here then?
What else can we do? Let these people have lunch, we'll go and spend some time somewhere.
Oh my god. From here the people look so tiny. Oh. Ajay, our marriage is so strange. No invitees, no celebrations. Ajay, tell me one thing.
Yes?
Which gift is that which the husband gives his wife for the first time after the wedding?
What?
I knew you'd forget. No problem. I've got it. See what's inside this.
It's very beautiful. Exactly like you.
Really?
Yes. You know, Seema, I wish that I could find a place for you in the skies. Like this.
Hey, Ajay, I'm scared. I have vertigo. Please put me down. I'm getting very scared.
Hey, now that you've put your trust in me, then why are you getting scared? I'm the crazy one who is taking you away from your world.
After marriage, every girl has to leave her own world and settle down in a new life with her husband.
And with these beautiful feel, the girl walks away from her old ties and is freed from them forever and ever. I'm going to free you, Seema. Please forgive me.
Control yourself.
Please leave me.
Priya, control yourself.
Stop, Priya. Please leave me.
Stop. Let's go, Priya. Let's go. Priya, come on.
Seema. Priya.
Get in. Let's
please
go.
Please let me go.
Take care of
me. Priya, get in.
No,
no, Priya, no.
I am very sorry for the death of Seema, Mr. Chopra. Would you please be able to give me some time in private?
Yes. Please come.
Mr. Chopra, till now we were thinking that Seema fell off that building or was made to fall off. But you know the truth is that she had committed suicide.
Seema committed suicide? How can that be possible?
Do you recognize this handwriting?
This is Seema's handwriting. But how is this possible? That day, she was so happy. And if she had any problems, she would have definitely told me. I'm her sister, and I know her very well. Seema can't do something like this, Dad. Seema? Seema can never commit a suicide. Seema can never do this, Dad. Seema can't commit a suicide, Dad. Seema cannot do this.
In my opinion, there is no doubt left, Mr. Chopra. But if you say, we'll continue the investigation. Otherwise, we'll close the case.
You do what you think is right, Commissioner. I have already lost my daughter.
This, Hey, why isn't this going in?
Keep trying, it will.
Babulal, This nail doesn't belong to this wall. It is for that wall.
Thank you.
What is it?
Is there anyone at home?
Is there anyone at home? Are you blind? Where this? Am I not standing here? Am I standing in the forest? Who are you?
Me? I'm Premnath.
Premnath? Shall I understand? Premnath. Look, we have stopped giving out donations. Just get out of here. Premnath. Looks like an orphan to me. God knows from where these people come from. Idiot.
Hey, Babulal. Why are you shouting? What happened?
God knows where these people come from asking for donations. I threw the stupid man out of the house.
And that's good.
Hello. I have come from BMG Jeweler Stores. Is Seema madam at home?
Tell me, what's the matter? I'm her sister.
A couple of days ago, she had come to our store. There is some money that we have to collect from her.
For what?
She had bought a wedding necklace from us.
Wedding necklace?
Yes.
There's surely been some misunderstanding.
But this is the address that she had given us. Take a look. Here's the bill.
What? I've been saying repeatedly Seema could not have committed suicide. It seems to me that the man whom she wanted to marry is the one who murdered her. Why don't you talk to the commissioner and restart the investigation?
No. I think there should not be any inquiry.
If Seema has been murdered, are you going to let her killer escape without punishment?
The murderer will get his punishment later. But how will we be punished? Have you ever thought of that? It will cause us a lot of embarrassment. Imagine Mr. Madan Chopra's daughter was having a clandestine affair with someone and was going to get married to him without telling anyone. And when this story hits the tabloids, the press, and everybody else will add to it and retell their own version, we will not be able to show our face to the world. Who will get married to you then? Have you thought of that? No, Priya. Seema has already died. And let her death be a sorrow which will stay in your heart. We cannot make it a source of embarrassment to us.
Come up, I get scared.
Come on, Seema, what's there to get afraid? The height is only 6 feet.
No. When I look down from a height, I get dizzy.
What's the matter, Priya? Why have you called me here?
Karan, Seema had not committed suicide.
How can you be so sure, in spite of having seen the suicide note written by her?
Because she had purchased a wedding necklace.
Wedding necklace?
Yes, and one day later she fell off this very building. And the marriage bureau is in this building. It's possible that Seema came here with somebody to get married. And the boy betrayed her and maybe he pushed her over the ledge.
Okay, assuming this boy pushed her over the wall. But the real question is, why does Seema want to marry him? Second thing. For registered marriage, you got to apply a month in advance. I've looked at the register. There is no application in the name of Seema Chopra. And the third thing is that we didn't find any wedding necklace from Seema's bag. Now you tell me, did she come here to get married or to commit suicide?
If she had to commit suicide, she could have shot herself. She could have taken poison. But she wouldn't have jumped out of a building. Because she was afraid of heights. If she looked down, she would get dizzy. You know, she couldn't even jump off a diving board which was 6 feet high.
They have closed the investigation. Now I can't help you in any way, Priya.
Please, Karan. To find the murderer of my sister, please help me. At this time, nobody is willing to help me.
All right. I can't do anything officially. But personally, I'll give you all the support I can. Now you do exactly what I tell you to do. First and foremost, you need to find all the people that Seema used to meet.
In fact, once I'd even asked her about the boy she was in love with. But she just avoided the issue, saying she'll tell me later.
But there is definitely someone who she was in love with, whom she wanted to marry. Is there somebody you doubt who could have been Seema's boyfriend?
I don't know outside the college. But in college, she used to meet up with Ravi.
Who is Ravi?
He's a classmate.
Can you tell me where I can find Ravi?
Well, in the evening in library.
Thanks, Anjali.
You're doubting me unnecessarily. Yes, I was in love with Seema. And I also thought that she was in love with me. But I realized my misunderstanding when I saw her with another boy in the garden.
Another boy? Who was he?
I don't know him. Yes, on Anjali's birthday I'd clicked a few photographs. He's there in one of those pictures.
Where are those pictures?
At my hostel. I'll give them to you tomorrow.
No. I want those photographs today itself.
You wait here. I'll go and get the photograph.
I'll come with you as well.
No.
This is a boys' hostel, so you cannot come up. You just wait here.
Sign on this. Sign on this. Take it. Sign on this. Fast. Sign this.
Excuse me? Excuse me? What is Ravi Shukla's room number?
Room number 65.
Thank you. Brought me here to show me Seema's boyfriend's picture. Then why did he kill himself?
Because he was lying. He didn't have any such picture. Ravi has himself accepted in suicide note that he was Seema's lover and also a murderer. And when you came here with him, he got scared that he might get caught and he killed himself because of that fear. Priya, your suspicion was absolutely right. Seema's boyfriend was in fact Seema's killer.
Please forgive me, Seema. Along with your life, I've also destroyed all the proofs that were related to your death. Because then I had no other option, Seema. Seema, I only betrayed you because
I wanted to win over the trust of your father. And the aim of my life is to destroy your father. And in order to obtain this aim, along with your death, today, Ajay will also have to die. Forgive me, Seema. Yes, Madan Chopra. From today, my double life has come to an end. The trust that I couldn't earn by being Ajay Sharma, that same trust I obtained by being Vicky Malhotra, in just one meeting at the Racing Avenue. Now get ready, Madan Chopra. It's time for you to be destroyed.
Hey, Fanso.
What?
It's been 6 months since Seema Madam passed away.
Yes, yes, yes.
But Babulal's investigation is still going on.
Yes.
Forget about us. He has even started doubting Mr. Chopra.
Oh, there he is.
I haven't seen anyone like Babulal in this world.
Oh. Hmm.
What is this? What is this?
Alcohol.
Talia, you're having alcohol?
No. You gave this to me last night after drinking.
Hide it, hide it, hide it.
Where are we going?
Office. Daddy wants to talk to you about something important.
What is so important?
How would I know? We will only be able to find out once we reach there.
Okay, that's fine. Yes, I'll have it done.
Come.
All right, I'll think about it, okay? Okay. Vicky, I have to talk to you about something personal.
Tell me.
Your story started with us at the race course. That day you lost the race in spite of almost having won it. I didn't take you as a student, but you made me your teacher. And after that, Seema died in an accident. I got a grip on myself. And you helped Priya to overcome the sorrow of her sister's death. You took your friendship with Priya further, causing her to be completely lost in you and waiting for you all the time. Slowly and gradually, you have taken over our lives completely. I am aware of every scheme and every step that you have taken. I know exactly why you have done all this. Because you and Priya are in love with each other. And I don't want to come in the way of that love. So I think you should call your parents immediately, so that I can get the two of you engaged with great celebrations.
Two years ago, the airlines mishap which happened at the Bangalore airport, in which everyone died, my parents were also amongst them.
But my parents are not in this world anymore.
What?
Yes. So 3 years ago, the air crash that took place in Bangalore, in which all the passengers died. My parents were also amongst them.
After today, I will never let you feel the loss of your parents. Come, son. Come, sit on this chair. And become a partner with me in running this huge Chopra empire. My partner with equal rights. Are you happy, baby? Now go, both of you, and celebrate.
No, sir. Today is a very big day for me. I would like to start work from today itself.
Very good. That's my boy. All the very best.
Thank you, sir.
Take care. Come, Priya.
Come home early in the evening.
Son, you want to apply color to her?
Yes.
My brother.
Huh?
Brother. Dear brother, please forgive me. I have been punished for my sins. Being in prison for 3 years has completely ruined my life. My wife died. My children don't have a mother anymore. I'm totally helpless. Totally helpless, my dear brother. Please have pity on me. My dear brother, I will do whatever you say. Where will I go with these two daughters, brother? Where will I go?
That's for you to think, not for me. I have always wanted you to be happy. I always thought of you as my own. I treated you like a real brother. What did I get in return? Betrayal?
Listen, what is he doing here?
Sister, please forgive me. Please forgive me. I'm really sorry for all the mistakes I have made. Please, sister, have pity on me, please. I swear on my elder daughter, Seema, that I will never make any more mistakes again. Please, please forgive me. Stop it, please.
Listen. Please forgive him. Everybody makes a mistake.
But Shobha?
Look, nobody will swear falsely on their children. And his tears are telling us that he has changed. I believe in him now.
All right. If you're saying, I will agree.
Thank you. Thank you, my sister.
Please, don't. It's okay.
Good morning.
Listen, yes, sir. Send the consignment of UGC Chemicals and also send the tender.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Desai?
Yes, sir. This is Madan, our old employee. From today, he will be working with you. All right? Yes, come along. Yes. Come, Madan.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Sit down, Madan.
Yes, sir.
Not there. Sit on the chair. Yes, sir.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
But Madan, the government doesn't approve of such projects.
It's my job to change the impossible to possible. You just do what you're being told.
Good morning, sir.
Hello, how are you? And get Mr. Sharma's signature on this form.
Good. You have certainly made a very good plan. Our company will stand to make a huge profit.
Thank you, sir.
Earlier too, I thought you were very capable and hardworking. Even today, I feel the same. That is why I have decided that from today onwards in this company, you will be a 5% partner.
5%?
Sir, company's directors are waiting for you in the conference room.
Oh, yes. Okay, Madan. You carry on. I'll see you later.
Okay, sir. Okay. 5%. Stupid man. I will become the 100% owner of this company and kick you out from here.
Keep this suitcase quickly in the car and come back here.
Yes, I'm going to Assam. You know, there I have bought a tea estate. It might be a few months before I come back. Well, this plantation work may take some long time.
Sir, what about the business here?
Don't worry about that. Madan will take care of everything.
Okay, sir.
Okay?
Okay, bye, sir.
Bye-bye. Yes, Madan.
Yes, sir.
I have checked all the order files.
Yes, sir.
Our permanent dealers, they should be given importance.
Yes, sir.
Don't let them complain about anything.
No, sir.
And yes, this is the power of attorney.
Yes, sir.
I have made it in your name.
Sir? In my name?
Yes. With this, you will not have any problems in operations of the company.
Dad, hurry up. We're getting late.
Yes, son. We are leaving. All right, Madan.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Vishwanath Sharma, you haven't given me the power of attorney. You have given me that property on which Madan Chopra will now start controlling your business.
You goddamn traitor! You lived in my house and stabbed me behind my back! I took pity on your children and gave you support. And instead you ruined me! You forgot all my favors? You forgot all the sympathy I gave you?
What sympathy are you talking about? 3 years ago I had done a small fraud of only 5 lakh rupees from your company. Only 5 lakhs. You could have forgiven me if you had wanted to. But instead you sent me to prison. And I had sworn at that time itself that I will destroy you one day. I will take everything from you. Actually, you were quite lucky that you gave me the power of attorney yourself. Otherwise, for this wealth, I could have even murdered you. Now get lost from here. And don't you dare ever come back here again.
After our proceedings are over, please have the police to look after the property so that until the auction, nobody touches any of the belongings.
Dad! Dad!
What's the matter, son?
Dad, look! These people have thrown us out of the house!
Huh? What's this? What's all going on here?
I'm sorry, Mr. Sharma. To repay back the loan that you have taken from the bank, we have been ordered to seize all the properties in your name in Assam and Mumbai, including your personal properties.
But I had not taken any loan.
The documents that we have with us, it shows that through Madan Chopra, you have taken an amount of 5 crores on interest. You have been sent a notice from the court 15 days ago. But since there was no response from your side, the court had to take the step.
But try and understand, my wife and children, they'll become homeless.
I'm sorry, I cannot do anything. But yes, if Madan Chopra wants to help, then he can surely do.
Oh! Hey, what is this? Why are you crying? No. These tears will make you look very pale. You want a house, isn't it? I will give you.
After all, kings and rulers have made mansions and palaces for prostitutes.
So can't I even give you a small flat? I know very well that beautiful women like you cannot live on the streets. Where will you sleep? Where will you bathe?
How dare you touch me, Madan Chopra? I am not a prostitute. I am Vishwanath Sharma's wife. Don't forget, even demons have not survived. They have been destroyed. Then who are you? Who do you think you are? Remember one thing, Madan. You will never be happy in your life. My children's curse will snatch away all your peace and happiness. You will be destroyed. You will be ruined. This is a mother's curse.
Your curses cannot cause any harm to me, stupid woman. None at all. Now everything here belongs to me. And I am the owner of everything.
Pack this also, please.
Hi, Priya.
Hi, Anjali.
How are you?
I am fine, but where have you been? I'd gone to your hostel, but I was told that you don't stay there.
Actually, I'm working at Hotel Hilltop as a receptionist. I stay there only. Why? Anything important?
Mm-hmm. I wanted to invite you for my engagement.
When is it?
Today evening, and you have to be there.
Today's a bit difficult because of the night shift. Had I known earlier, I would have taken a holiday.
Shall we go, Priya?
Vicky, this is Seema's best friend, Anjali. And Anjali, this is my fiancé, Mr. Vicky Malhotra.
Hello.
Hello.
I think I've seen you somewhere before.
You might have. The world is a small place, isn't it? Come on, Priya, you have to go to the beauty parlor.
Okay, Anjali.
Congratulations in advance to both of you. All the best.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I think I have seen you somewhere before.
You must have. The world is a small place.
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
How are you?
Please come. Congratulations, sir.
Come, come.
Good evening, congratulations.
Nice to see you.
Madam, drinks?
Hey, Fatso, look over there. Huh? Babu Lal has forgotten to put the drinks in the glass.
Mm.
And is walking around with empty glasses on the tray.
Want some? Mr. Batra!
I am not Mr. Batra, I'm Mr. Wadhwa.
Oh, Mr. Wadhwa, please have some drinks. It's nice. Please, please take some, please.
No, thank you.
What do you want?
No, thank you, thank you.
Good evening, Inspector Karan.
Good evening, uncle.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Please come in, please. Hello.
Priya, have all your friends come or some are yet to come?
Hi,
Karan.
Vicky, congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Priya.
Thank you.
Friends, Mr. Chopra's daughter Priya is getting engaged today with Vicky Malhotra. And on this happy occasion, a lovely song will be sung by India's very talented singer, Mr. Vinod Rathor.
छुपाना भी नहीं आता, छुपाना भी नहीं आता, जताना भी नहीं आता। हमें तुमसे मोहब्बत है, बताना भी नहीं आता, छुपाना भी जताना भी नहीं आता। छुपाते हैं जुबां पे बात है लेकिन सुनाना ही नहीं आता। हमें तुमसे
Hello.
Is this a Chopra's residence?
So you think I'm speaking from the telephone exchange?
Please, can you call Priya? I want to talk to her urgently.
Look now, for a girl, there is nothing more important than her own engagement. She is very busy right now. She cannot come on the phone.
Look, I have been trying for 2 hours and I got through with great difficulty. I want to say something about Seema.
Huh? You want to say something about Seema?
Yes. Tell Priya that Anjali has called up and she wants to say something about Seema and...
One minute. I'll forget everything. 1 minute. Anjali has called up and she wants to say something about Seema madam. Am I right? 1 minute please. Anjali has called up. She wants to say something important about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Please move. Please move. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam. Anjali has called up. 1 minute. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam.
Babulal.
Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam.
What are you saying?
Anjali has called up. She wants to talk about Seema madam.
Oh, never mind. Go and get me an ice cream.
Oh, I'll forget everything. Anjali has called up. She wants to talk
about
Seema madam.
I told you to go and get me an ice cream. Come on, go.
You want ice cream?
Yes.
Anjali has called up. I'm not getting you the ice cream. Anjali
Thank
has called up.
Thank you so much. I know.
Excuse me. Madam. Like... Madam.
Yeah?
There's a call for you.
Anarkali?
Anarkali has called.
Why not?
And it's important to have ice cream.
What?
You don't worry.
Anarkali has called
yes.
and says it's important to have ice cream. Anarkali? Ice cream?
Yeah.
Anarkali has called.
Babulal, what's the matter?
Anarkali has called. It's very important to eat ice cream.
What? What rubbish? Have you been drinking?
Drinking? No, sir.
Babulal, get out of here. Come on, go. Get out.
This old man doesn't let me do any important work. I'm sure there's something wrong here. Sometimes I have doubts on him as well.
Hello?
Who's speaking?
I'm Chopra speaking. Priya's daddy.
Hello, uncle. This is Seema's friend, Anjali speaking.
Yes, Anjali. Tell me.
Well, actually, I met Priya at the jewelry shop today. There she introduced me to Vicky. Uncle, Vicky looks exactly like the boy who was Seema's boyfriend.
How can you be so sure about this?
I have seen his picture.
Picture?
Yes, he's there in the photographs which were taken at my birthday party.
Have you mentioned this to anybody else?
No, I thought it was important to tell Priya first.
That's good. Very good. Look, Anjali, don't even mention this to anybody else. Because this is a question of the honor of our family. I hope you're understanding what I'm saying. Huh? By the way, where are you right now?
Hotel Hilltop, staff quarters, room number 9.
Okay. You wait there only. I'll get Priya and come.
Is it okay if I use your phone?
Oh, yes. Of course.
Thanks.
I hope you're enjoying the party.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Hey, you?
I have come to bother you.
Come sit.
Thanks. Have you seen this girl before?
She's Anjali, Seema's friend. I met her 2 days back.
On the night of engagement, had you spoken to Anjali on the phone?
No, but what's the matter?
Anjali is missing since that night.
Missing?
After making inquiries at that hotel, I came to know that approximately at 10:30 in the night, she had called him.
I was busy at the party.
Hmm.
Babulal,
hmm?
On the night of the engagement party, did a girl named Anjali call up?
Oh.
Madam, tell me one thing.
What?
Whose engagement party was it?
Babulal, that was my engagement.
Oh, yes, yes, it was a great party. We all had great fun, you know.
Now
I know.
Try to remember and tell me, did any girl named Anjali call for me?
Okay. If you come to know anything, just call me up. I'll take your leave.
Okay.
Hello, Inspector.
Oh, hello.
How come you here?
Vicky, Karan is here to inquire about Anjali.
Who Anjali?
Seema's friend who met us at the jewelry shop the other day.
Yes.
Seema's friend? I remember! I had answered Anjali's phone. I had answered it. And she had told me, give the phone to Priya. I want to tell her something about Seema.
About Seema? Then why didn't you call me?
I was coming to call you, but somebody stopped me.
Who stopped you?
Huh? Madam, please give me 2 days' time. I will remember and I'll tell you.
Hey, why are you listening to this forgetful man?
Mm-hmm.
It's stupidity to believe in what he says.
Mm.
Come on, go from here.
Mm?
Go.
Mm. Sometimes I have my doubts on this Vicky also. Mm? Mm.
Okay, I'll take your leave now.
Yes, Inspector.
Yeah.
See you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Priya, how many times should I tell you
hey,
that...
Hey, Vicky.
Hmm.
On the night of engagement when I came into the drawing room, you were talking to somebody on the phone.
What are you trying to say? That day, Mr. Madan Chopra's daughter got engaged. Inspector Karan? Not just any ordinary person. There were a lot of calls to congratulate. And I'm sorry, Inspector, I wasn't aware that you were going to inquire. Otherwise, I would have made a list of all the calls. Hmm?
I'm sorry, Vicky. I was just doing my normal inquiry. Anyway, I'm sorry to bother you. Bye.
Vicky, it's possible that Anjali wanted to tell us something about Seema's death?
Priya. It's been over a year since Seema's death. And now, even her murderer has committed suicide.
Yes, but it is also possible
Nothing is possible. You don't know these police officers. They make a living out of investigating these old cases. Priya, I'm sorry, Priya. Priya, I was so happy. Having thoughts that my love had made you forget Seema's sorrow. But this man has... again, revived Seema's memories for you. Yes?
Vicky, I want to talk to you about something important. Come to my cabin immediately. And please come quickly. I have to leave for the airport in 5 minutes.
Okay, I'll be right there.
Thank you.
Mr. Chopra, the power of attorney can only be given to someone you trust completely.
Oh ho, where's the question of trust now? And Vicky is no stranger, he's going to become my son-in-law.
Okay, Mr. Chopra, I'll take your leave.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.
Sir, It's time for your flight, sir.
Oh yes. Why has Vicky not come as yet? Vicky? Vicky? Where has Vicky gone? I've been looking for you all over.
Sorry, sir. I couldn't hear your voice.
Never mind. Come with me. After the conference in London, I will have to go to Germany in connection with the technical collaboration.
Yes, sir.
It's going to take a long time there, so I have made this power of attorney in your name. With this, you can take any decision for the benefit of the company as Madan Chopra.
Sir, it's time for you to leave now.
Oh, yes. Okay, Vicky. All the best.
All the best to you,
sir. I'm sure you will do a good job.
Thank you.
Come on, Desai.
Yes, sir.
This is the day I've been waiting for, Madan Chopra. You have not just given me a power of attorney, but you have given me the opportunity which I can use as and when I want to write the course of your destruction.
Mr. Vicky, you are making wrong use of the power of attorney.
Mr. Desai, please be concerned with your work only. What's right and what's wrong? I know that much better than you.
But sir... Johnny! Huh?
Looking at the increasing rate of crime, this morning the commissioner has informed the media that in the affected areas, police security has been increased. The police constables are given the right guidance. In another incident, according to the police, the body found in the suitcase on the beach has been identified. It is of a lady who worked for Hilltop Hotel. Her age was approximately 20 years, and her name was Anjali Sinha.
Hello, Inspector Karan speaking.
This is Priya here.
Yes, tell me, Priya.
Just now I saw on TV that Anjali's body was found on the beach.
Yes, I know. And I was coming to your house to talk to you about it.
No, Karan. You don't come here. I don't want Vicky or Daddy to know anything about this.
Then where should we be?
You do one thing. You meet me at the Sun and Sand coffee shop right now. Okay?
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Priya. Hey. What's the matter? You're looking very worried. Whose phone was it?
My friend had called up. I'm going to her house to meet her.
Come, I'll drop you to her place.
You don't bother. I'll go by myself. I'll just go and get ready.
Up till now, we thought Seema's killer was Ravi. But after Anjali's death, it seems Ravi is not the murderer but somebody else. And that person has killed Ravi and Anjali.
But Ravi had himself written in the suicide note that he was Seema's lover and murderer also.
The murderer is very intelligent, Priya. He has used the same weapon in killing Seaman Ravi. Suicide note. Whoever tried to inform us about Seema was killed. Ravi wanted to show you Seema's killer's photograph. And according to what Babulal said, Anjali also wanted to tell you something about Seema.
Then who could be the killer?
Whoever it is. He's keeping a watch on your every move. Anyway, no matter how smart he is, he will definitely be caught one day.
Where had you gone? I've been waiting for you since a long time.
I had told you, I'm going to meet a friend of mine.
What is your friend's name? Miss Karan?
Even if I had gone to meet Karan, what's wrong with that?
Wrong? It's not wrong to meet him. It's wrong to meet him on the sly. What's the problem, by the way? Why do you keep going to meet him? Sometimes at police station, sometimes at coffee shop, sometimes at his house. If you're so fond of meeting him, then why don't you meet him in front of me, Priya?
You are doubting me, Vicky? You want to know, right? Why do I go and meet Karan without telling anyone? You and my father are the cause of this. Whenever I tried to talk about Seema's murder, you didn't support me and neither did Daddy. I had to go to Karan for help. And today it's because of him that I have come to know that my sister's killer is still alive. And how could you think of something so cheap between me and Karan? God! You should be ashamed of yourself, Vicky. I could never imagine of that.
I'm sorry, Priya. My anger, my jealousy, my suspicion is all a result of my love. I love you very much, Priya. I love you so much that even if somebody just looks at you, I get extremely angry. And today, for a moment, the fear of losing you occurred to me. And perhaps that's why I said all these things to you. You're not just my love, but also my passion. Priya, I cannot live without you.
Vicky, please don't ever doubt on me again. I am only yours, just yours.
So let's go. Let's go and celebrate our love.
काली काली आँखी ये गोरे गोरे गाल ये तीखी तीखी नजरें ये हिरनी जैसी चाल ये काली काली आँखें ये गोरे गोरे गाल ये तीखी तीखी नजरें ये हिरनी जैसी चाल देखा जो तुझे
काली काली आँखें, ये गोरे गोरे का, ये तीखी तीखी नजरें, ये हिरनी जैसी चाल। मिली मैं मिला दुनिया जले तो जले प्यार करेंगे तुझ पे मरेंगे धक धक दिल ये करे जलाने लगी दिलरुबा तू मुझे नखरे दिखाने लगी छोड़ो जी छोड़ो सनम जिद अपनी छोड़ो सनम नाजुक है दिल ये मेरा दिल को ना तोड़ो सनम दिल को ना तोड़ो सनम ये लंबी लंबी रातें कर ले मुलाकातें जाने क्यों दिल ये मेरा तेरा ही होना चाहे उसे में लाल ना कर ये गोरे गोरे का ये काली काली आँखें ये गोरे गोरे का ये तीखी तीखी नजरें ये हिरनी जैसी ये बिखरी बिखरी जुल्फें ये झुकी झुकी पलकें ये गोरी गोरी बाहें हम क्यों ना तुम्हें चाहें ऐसा तो हमने पहले देखा नहीं कमाल ये काली काली आँखें ये गोरे गोरे का तीखी तीखी नजरें ये हिरनी जैसी चाल
God, you're happy now.
Ajay! Hi! I'll be right back.
Come on, Priya. Let's go somewhere else.
Let's have dinner at least.
Oh no, we'll eat somewhere else. Come.
Ajay, that was great. You danced so well. Fantastic. Very nice.
Maybe you have had a lot to drink. My name is not Ajay. Good night.
Hey,
let's
Ajay.
Go, Priya.
Why are you joking, yeah? I haven't had so much drinks that I don't recognize my childhood friend, huh?
You're a strange man. I just told you that my name is not Ajay, nor am I your friend. Come on, Priya.
Okay. Girl is with you, that's why you're acting pricey.
Vicky, please. Look, there has been some misunderstanding. His name is not Ajay, but Vicky Malhotra.
Vicky Malhotra? Vicky Malhotra is not his name, it's my name. He's lying. Ajay, what's going on? Why are you using my name? Huh?
You?
Hey, what's going on? What's going on? Stop it! Stop it! Leave him! Leave him, I said, leave him! Leave him! Hey, stop it! Leave him!
You raised your hand on me? You hit your own friend? Who do you think you are? How could you know about friendship? What do you think of yourself?
I'm sorry, Priya.
To get the girl, you're using my name? Vicky Malhotra's name? I am Vicky Malhotra! Leave me! You know, he's my childhood friend. I've done him a lot of favors. He's forgotten everything I did for him. Get out, I don't need your friendship. What kind of friend he is?
My parents are not in this world anymore. So 3 years ago, the air crash that took place in Bangalore, in which all the passengers died. My parents were also amongst them. Ajay, this is not the time to think. It's time to decide. You have come here to destroy the Chopra family. To ruin his entire family. Priya's love is just incidental. Every time you wanted to achieve your aim, Priya's love has stopped you. But the day she gets to know the truth, she is going to hate you. She's going to hate you, Ajay. Ajay, your aim is to destroy Chopra. Only destruction.
Desai, what is all this?
Sir, Vicky has taken over all the companies.
What? Vicky! Betrayer! Traitor! You have cheated me out of all my hard-earned money! Who is this Sharma? To whom you have sold everything and you have brought me onto the streets? But you don't know who you have betrayed, you fool! Madan Chopra is my name! Madan Chopra!
Birds are expected to fly, Madan Chopra. Not broken wings.
Vicky!
Don't shout! Remember. Try and remember the race course. You didn't make me your disciple. But I made you my guide and lost a winning race to you. Because winning the race was not my aim. My aim was this. This chair. Time. Time has come back to the same place, Madan Chopra. Everything. Everything is happening just as it did 15 years earlier. Remember, Chopra. Try and remember that great man who gave you his entire support. And who you had betrayed in the same manner. I am the son of that Vishwanath Sharma. Ajay Sharma.
Thank you.
Do you remember? That day you were sitting here and my mom was standing right there and asking you to give back what was rightfully hers. This is the same chair, Madan Chopra, on which you sat and wrote death for my father and sister, trauma for my mother, and homelessness and misery for me. But today, each and every property of yours, I've written my father's name on it. And even if you want to, you cannot cause any harm to me. Because right now, your condition is like that handicapped man who uses crutches to walk with, but has no hands to hold them with. And yes, Mr. Madan Chopra, without an appointment, please don't dare to come into my office. Okay? Out.
Three years ago, the Bangalore air crash that took place, Mr. and Mrs. Malhotra were among the people who died. Can I have their address, please?
1 minute. The address is 52B, Shanti Kunj, Varsova Road, Mumbai 58.
Come. I know that you have come here to find out who the real Vicky Malhotra is, right? I am the real Vicky Malhotra. And the person who was with you, his name is Ajay. The same Ajay, he used to study in the school with me. I supported him whenever he was in trouble. And that same Ajay insulted me in front of so many people. I am not upset he refused to recognize me. I'm upset because he hit me. On his friend? This is the way he repays me back? I can't understand why. Why he's calling himself Vicky Malhotra? How do you know him?
He's my fiancé.
He's a liar. And if you still don't believe what I'm saying, then go and ask his mother, who still stays in Panvel sector number 12.
Vicky. What should I call you? Vicky Malhotra or Ajay Sharma? While calling yourself by another name and committing all these sins, maybe you forgot that by changing a name, a person cannot change his identity or his sins. The cruel way in which you had pushed my sister off the building. Nobody even throws a toy out of the window like that. And not just that. You betrayed me as well. You pretended to be in love with me. Why? What harm had we caused you? My father did everything for you. He made you a partner in all his happiness. And in return for that, this is how you repay us? If all you wanted was wealth, you should have asked my father for it. He would have given it to you as charity.
Charity? What kind of property are you talking about, huh? The property of which your father had made himself, the king of Chopra Empire, that property? That belonged to my father. And it is mine. The man who thinks his daughter's death is a source of defamation, that respectful father of yours. I know what kind of a man he is. What did he ever had? He was the one who had to come to our threshold as a beggar. And my parents gave him support, you know? And in return for that, he snatched away everything that we had. He brought us onto the streets. Just think of what the child must have gone through. When your cheap, useless father had tried to molest his mother so brutally. You don't know, Priya. All the atrocities that your father has done. You have always only seen him with a crown on his head. But just try to look beyond that, and you will see my innocent father and my helpless sister's blood. Today also I remember that night when your father had inflicted the most painful sorrow on my entire family.
Mom, will Muni become all right?
Go and get some cold water.
Okay, Mom.
It's okay, baby. Oh, my sweetheart.
Has her fever lessened?
No. It's increasing.
All right. I'll get some medicines.
Where are you going? The doctors have asked you to rest.
A person who has so many problems. For that person, resting is also a problem.
Wait. Take care of her. Take this. If instead of Muni, had I been unwell, then I would have never removed this. Listen,
No!
Mom? Mom, just look what happened to Munni.
Today also, I can see in front of my eyes my father's burning pyre and my sister's body, which has not let my tears dry up. Hey, you have just been inflicted a small pain, but I have been stabbed by a dagger. You know, 3 wounds were inflicted on me, and these wounds have not been healed till today. Do you want to see? Do you want to see? Come. Come with me. Fifteen years have passed. But her tears have not stopped flowing. Even till today. Priya, I have passed my entire childhood without her love. This is my mother. I have not forgotten. But she doesn't even remember that I am her son.
I'll be back.
Dad? Ajay! Ajay!
Move aside, Priya! This man has ruined us! He is a betrayer!
You are lying to me! I very well know now who is the fraud here! He is not a cheat, you are!
Move from here! Take it away!
Leave me!
You don't realize who you have dared to confront. I will finish you and destroy you completely. Hit him! What were you thinking? That you will be able to take away my wealth so easily? Madan Chopra is my name! Madan Chopra! Come on, hit him! Keep hitting him!
That beautiful woman like you cannot live on the streets. Where will you sleep? Where will you be?
Kill this useless fellow!
Madan Chopra?
Come on, kill the bastard! Hit him and go on hitting him!
Madan Chopra.
Leave! Leave him! Leave my son! Leave him! Leave my son! Madan Chopra! Madan Chopra, how dare you hit my son!
So far, I have only shot him and injured him. But if this fool doesn't sign these property papers, I will make so many small pieces of his body that you won't even be able to count them.
A mother counts her son's future, counts blessings, not the pieces of his body. If anything happens to my son, then I will make countless pieces of your body. I will be the one to kill you. I will kill you, Madan Chopra.
Mom. What happened, Mom? Mom.
The blood which has become tears in my mother's eyes for past 15 years cannot be controlled anymore. Now there will be an outburst, Madan Chopra. Outburst. With this hand you had hit my mother, right? This is the hand you had raised on my mother. Rightfully ours, Mom.
Yes.
I have ended the storm.
Yes.
Which had made us helpless, Mother. Now, Now, you will not have any sorrows, mother. No sorrows at all.
For a mother, what can be more sorrowful than her son? Her son lying injured in her lap, and she is not able to do anything about it.
Maybe this is what I deserved, Mom.
No.
Deserved, Mom. Today. Today, after so many years, I feel very peaceful lying here in your lap, Mom. Mom.
Yes.
Please hold me in your arms, Mom.
Yes,
please,
my
hold
son.
Me in your arms, Mom.
My Mom, son.
I've been waiting since childhood to get this love, Mother. Now. Now, I want to sleep peacefully, Mom. I want to sleep peacefully.
Okay. Sleep. Sleep. My son, sleep. After so many years, you are here in my lap. No, Ajay. Ajay. No, Ajay. My son. Ajay, no. No.
For more entertainment, log on and subscribe to www.youtube.com/venusmovies.